Now we'll see the working of the communication unit. First of all, we have to enter the contact details. Here it is asking for the password. Now it is successfully logged in, and here it is asking for the mobile number of the attendant, the nursing station and the doctor. Let me fill it one by one. Now let me fill the email IDs. Now I am saving the contact details. Now the contact details has been saved, and we'll go for the communication process now. So for that I have to manually activate the system. Here I am pressing the start button. Now it is activated. Now we'll see the processes. Call attendant. The call to attendant has been initiated. Here you can see the attendant mobile number is ringing. You can see it is saved as ICU, bed number 10. Next, call nursing station. Now the call to nursing station has been initiated. You can see the nursing station mobile is ringing. Next, call doctor. Call to doctor has been initiated. Here you can see the doctor's mobile phone is ringing. Next, email to all. Now the mail has been sent to the attendant and the doctor and the nursing station. We'll show you the outcomes at the end. Now I am calling the patient intentionally. Here you can see the incoming call to the patient. And I need to end this call without any answer. End the call. Now the call has been ended. And I have to manually deactivate the system. I am pressing the stop button. Now the system is deactivated. I am exiting it. Now let's check the emails. The first one is the recipient number 1, that is the attendant, and here you can see the an incoming email. The subject line is please attend the patient Bishwajit Champati ICU BN number 10, and here are the recipient details. Who got this? Let's move to the recipient number 2, that is the nursing station. Here is the same, the subject line is same, and let's move to the recipient number 3, doctor's email ID. Here you can see the same email and with the same subject line.